make way. Strange one.
What's up, Evil Dead fans? This is the first video on how to build an Army of Darkness chainsaw to detail. Now, first and foremost, before we get too far into this, I have to apologize. Guys, I grew up in the Midwest, lower Midwest, and I've really lost my accent, and I try to speak fast, and my accents kind of get screwy a little bit, so, and also I have a little bit of a speech impediment. So, if you've talked to me on the phone, you've heard me stutter, or my language gets a little weird, I do apologize for that. I will try to be as clear as possible when it comes to doing this tutorial. So, if you see a video that says Army of Darkness build, number one, number two, number three, we're going to go specifically by detail on how to build this, because I will never sell one of these, ever. There's a lot of detail into these chainsaws. certain ways to do them, and really they kind of, it was kind of a cobbled up chainsaw the way they did it, because it really wasn't very specific in the movie. So first and foremost, let's go over the side handle. Now the side handle, you would notice here, it's not rounded like Ash vs. Evil Dead. It's actually at a slight angle cut. Once it starts getting fat, your side handle, once you get a side handle, it starts getting fat right here. That's gonna be your angle cut. And then you wanna get some sandpaper and slightly round the sides. And this is the handle look from when it's sitting in the gravel at the beginning of the movie. That's what this look is. So remember, when it starts getting a little fat right here, and basically when it starts getting fat, like, doing any of the chainsaws, especially like Ash vs. Evil Dead, you want to straight cut and add some milliput, or leave a little more around it and add milliput, whatever. But talking about Army of Darkness, you want to angle cut it right before it gets fat, and then just slightly round it with some sandpaper. Don't get crazy with the sandpaper, but that's the look that you want. Very simple to do, does not take long to do. next thing we're going to look at the muffler piece. Now, if you've seen the scene where it's sitting in the gravel, you will notice where it's sitting, you will see this little gap here. And also, when it's coming down from the sky, when he puts his nub into it, you will see it like this. Now, with the block from here, this measurement here, and this measurement here, if I remember right, it's 2 1/4. Should be 2 1/4. This is 2.5. This is slightly smaller than 2.5, just slightly, basically by like 1/8 of an inch. When it sits in the body, you will notice it won't sit since I don't have a backing here. It sits like this. Notice there is a gap in the bottom. Now, this side was actually pushed up just a little bit to give it more of a gap when it's coming down onto Ash's nub, little stub. there's two things you can do with this bolt right here. They both have to be flathead bolts or screws, whatever you have. If you're doing the working one that you see, like from the beginning of the film where it's Evil Dead, the recap, or Evil Dead 2, the recap, or it's from the windmill scene, it's the rounded top bolt or screw. Now, if you're doing it from falling, it's falling from the sky, you have to do it flat. And this is the proper angle for this piece here. Now, going over the block with here. If you've seen the movie, of course, we've all seen Army of Darkness. It seems like it's almost a quarter of an inch longer when it sits in the body, but like this. If you leave it a quarter of an inch longer, then where you put your cuff attachment and stuff really will hinder it. So I really think this is what you should do, right here to here. When it comes to making this piece right here, let me get this. The muffler piece, so you have a stock muffler piece right here. Notice how this one's thinner. You have to cut it just a little more in half. Basically, where you see this line right here, you want to cut that all the way around to get it this thick. Now, the next thing you want to do is, and this is not in final paint by any means, you want to take your Dremel with a blade and you want to cut this right here, and then you want to hammer down this edge. And all I used was like a metal one-inch bar kind of thing, like a thin piece of metal, thin bar, something similar to this, and put a hammer on top of it, just hammered it down before I attached it, of course, to get that nice flat look. And when you actually cut this, make sure you put that kind of rounded look here. This top right here should be almost flush with the top. This corner should be against the edge and then come back up, so you get that proper look. And like I said, it's not a final paint or anything like that. I'm gonna add some more black paint and then some silver paint as well. Dealing with the look of the Army of Darkness chainsaw, I'm really going with that nub look. You really don't have to make the block look super nice because it looks like wood in the movie. But I will add some more paint, some more detail here and there to make it a little more accurate. But, you know, basically that's what you want. So that covers that. When it comes to the chainsaw body, when it's falling out of the sky and he grabs it with his nub, one thing you'll notice here, it's the same cut as Ash vs. Evil Dead on this side right here. Also, one difference here, this little edge, if you have a Homelite XL, this little edge, it's gone, completely gone. There's a little kind of a kick up here, and then it's brought back down for the cuff. There was also two bolt holes on this side and three on this side. If you see it when it's actually falling out of the sky, when he's reaching up to get it, it has more of the proper look to get that. When he actually gets it with his nub, it's a little closer with the bolt heads, so they look really close. So this hole right here is an extra bolt for something I don't know. This one's for the strap. This one's for the strap and two extra bolts right here. And they're all flathead bolts with the rounded tops. If you're going for that look, if you're going for the working look, they didn't have all these, but I really want that side look of that one. Also with the top, with this specific body that I got, this is the right body. I did have to modify it a little bit. The block on this one wasn't wide enough, so I molded the block. I put the hole for the bolt up here in the proper place. Right here, this little dip is where the dirt goes into. This bolt right here, there's gonna be a bolt head up here. Remember, it's a flathead bolt, it's rounded. Same with these two back here. So if you have Allen head bolts that you used on your Ash vs. Evil Dead ones, chainsaws, they are not on this one. Everything is a rounded flathead bolt. You can do it on this one, like I said, or you can do this look with the flat one, but it has to be a flathead bolt pattern. No hex bolts, but if you don't have the money to go pick up bolts here and there or anything like that, use whatever you have. You're just gonna lose a little bit of screen accuracy. That's really what's gonna happen. So with this, you're gonna have a bolt here, and two over here, which will hold in your block. Now, when it comes to the block here, That scene where he's grabbing it with his nub, there is no motor backing here. There's actually like a V-shaped or almost an L-shaped piece of metal that comes up. I will put that in, but I will also put in a backing, like a motor backing, and blocking it out just so there's no gaps. Because that scene was a nub, just the nub connecting into it. But of course, my hand will be in it, so I want to cover that up. So I will have a inner backing underneath the block here. This chainsaw is going to be very in-depth. If you guys really want to make a really cool and accurate Army of Darkness chainsaw, you're going to want to follow. Because a lot of people, they made them, but we're going to make sure that this one specifically is going to be the most accurate that's ever been reproduced. Went over this already. You want that look. I know it's from the side. It's got that nice short look. Got that nice cut in there. Remember I did this with a Dremel. You can cut this with a Dremel if you want to. The muffler piece with a blade, or you can use an air tool, whatever you have. But just look at the difference in size here. It's massive. And also, guys, well, hold on. I'll get to that. So this is done. Went over that. Went over this. And also went over this. Remember, where it gets a little fat here, angle cut it, and then round it out slightly. That's the look you want. You don't have to milliput anything, nothing like that, unless you screw up. This one I won't repaint or anything like that. Black or add any texturing, because it's gotta look like this. Like how it looked when they pulled it out of the gravel, or it was dropped down at the beginning of the movie. Same with these bolt holes. These ones are all the same. When it comes to cutting the body, you want to leave just a little bit of this right here. You want about a good eighth of an inch of this left. Now, you got to figure out your measurements for yourself there. The top will not extend to this line. It will come to this line and come across. It will not extend down. So, it's not like Ash vs. Evil Dead. It will not extend down to this line. It will come across up here. And, yeah. Oh, and by the way, I have all the bars I need ordered for the definitive set. I got the Army of Darkness one coming. And also, I was able to get a nice Oregon bar for Evil Dead 2 for like $21 with the chain. And I tell you what, that was a steal, because Oregon bars and chains are not cheap. They're like 40, 50, 60 bucks. They can go even higher than that, especially in a set. So when I was able to get it from this guy, it was like on a, gosh damn, my nose is running, sorry guys. When I was able to get it from him off a garage sale site, we met him at the mall and picked it up. This is what I did.
Thank you, generous host!
So yeah, I gave the money and I took my ass off and I was out of there. Brand new set, brand new bar and chain. So this is the first video on making your Army of Darkness chainsaw. Hope to help you guys out. And, you know, very simple detail to do that will take a little longer time just to make sure it's accurate. You can reference a lot of other people. But if you want it really, really accurate, you're going to have to either do some research for yourself or follow me. So, guys, until next time, I'm going to keep building. And I think the next video probably will be over the cuff, which is gonna be a pain in my ass. So until next time, guys, stay groovy.